out, and the board's been flexed because of this. So when you screw these in, you torque them down, obviously, and you can kind of see the board even moving as I unscrew these. The reason that the X-clamp was put into place is because they knew this board was going to flex. It flexes constantly. And those X-clamps would actually allow the board to shift and move on its own. So they did have some give to them, but they would also hold the heatsink flush to the GPU. And it was an interesting way to make it work. I know people yell about the X-clamp, but it did actually have a purpose, and there was a reason to use that. They at least used one plastic, very, very wide plastic washer on the top. And they definitely went to town with the thermal compound, as you can see there. Oh man, this 360 unfortunately is kind of a lost cause. I don't even know if it's worth spending any time with, just because of what's happened to it so far. However, I will be cleaning this off so we can take a look at the CPU and the GPU and everything. CPU is a tri-core power PC, and then the GPU was interesting because it had a few.
You're about to embark on an adventure, a journey into a world of passion, emotions, and challenge. You'll ride the most beautiful motorcycles ever created. These bikes are so incredible that they sometimes transcend their mechanical nature and reveal a soul worthy of the best riders. They hold inside the dreams and ideas of their creators, and their hearts of steel speak to our very instincts. Speed, style, adrenaline, or pleasure, whatever your nature, if you've come here, you belong to this world. Everything you've ever dreamt of is here before you, and no matter your goal, here you'll find the perfect companion to reach it. Welcome to the heart of your passion. Welcome to Ride 3.
Sometimes you can leave it on a heater, believe it or not, the preheat, and it would actually straighten itself out, especially when it was kind of put into a jig. And, oh man, this is a real shame, because this is one of the newer GPUs before they went to that. I can already tell because of the die size. Before they went to that that slim design, this is kind of a shame because this actually would have lasted if it was done correctly. I don't even know if this was a red ring. They might have just done this as like a precaution, but it's been so damaged at this point. That's a shame. This might be one of the like very, very new ones. Usually the die size on these is much larger. This larger die here is generally much closer to this smaller one. Yeah, so this is a GPU that was used in some of the elites at the time going into 2010. And it is a very new one. Generally, they ran a little cooler. That kind of power supply is only 150 watts as opposed to the some of the first models.
We believe the value of a motorcycle can't be measured. But performance points will help gauge its potential on the track.
We have RAM modules around. Remember, I had 512 megabytes of RAM. However, it was one big pool of RAM, which was an issue with the PS3, where they divided RAM chips up, where they actually put RAM directly on the GPU and the PS3 and then around the CPU. And they were trying to make it so that it was faster to access that memory, but they also, Microsoft also put very fast RAM on the GPU as well, 10 megabytes of that to help cache and textures and upscaling and everything, just extra fast memory that was available at the time to the GPU, and it worked out. Most ports ran better on the 360. Of course, if developers took specific advantage of the PS3, you would get games like Uncharted, right? You get those kind of games that look tremendous. Metal Gear Solid 4, which is one of the best in the generation. But the 360 was much better in terms of third-party support. Go to like, something like Bayonetta, for example. That was a disaster on the PS3. So let me show you what I'm talking about with this flexing. So if you heat this board up, which as systems work, they do get hotter. We all know that. That's why they have fans, that's why they blow out hot air. This 360 board was generally flexed. And that's because it's a very thin board. You kind of see how easy it is to flex when it's cold. Now when it gets hot, even small flexing will actually manage to break solder molds and fracture them. So when it's hot, it's even easier to flex this board. And you can kind of see how that works. So when you take screws and washers and you don't know really what you're doing, and you start pulling these corners will actually pull up to the heatsink, and at that time you have a very, very, very messed up level around here. So you can already kind of, I can already feel with my finger running around. It feels like it's got like a divot or a ditch kind of around that GPU. And at that point, you're in trouble because this system's going to shift and warp and move, and the screws won't allow it to do that. At that point, the GPU suffers and you get a red ring. But yeah, guys, that is an Xbox 360 refurbished from GameStop. Not a good look. This was not a good system to pick up because it kind of went through, like I said, the ringer with screws and washers and a fan mod, and it's a whole lot.